Justice, geared reassessment of ecological and environmental needs to justly utilize sustainable techniques in communities everywhere. My name is Jessica Albrecht, and presenting with me today is Nadja Mateen and Caleb Keith. Okay, so the world throws away more than 2 billion tons of garbage every year, according to Martin Medina, leading environmental expert. So with this in mind, what do we think the Great Wall of China and Fresh Hills Landfill have in common?
Visible from outer space.
You're correct. These are the only two man-made structures that can be seen from space. So on the left, you can see Fresh Hills Landfill, and on the right is the Great Wall of China. Landfills are filling up at a higher rate than ever before. We are running out of room. And why are landfills a problem, other than just the space issue? Landfills pose environmental costs, social costs, and economic costs to our world. So environment costs. To prevent leakage in landfills, there's a system, a landfill liner. The bottom liner prevents trash from coming into contact with outside soil, particularly the groundwater. So when a landfill leaks, toxins would escape directly into the environment through air, water, and soil. And according to the Leak Location Services, 82% of surveyed landfill cells in the U.S. leak every year. So basically all landfills leak, and these toxins are getting into our environment. Social costs. People living near landfills suffer from increased health risks, including increased risks of cancer, birth defects, and respiratory infections. And to give you an idea of some economic costs, each year 36 billion aluminum cans or last year, 36 billion aluminum cans landfill had a scrap value of more than $600 million. So each year, Marylanders throw away enough trash to build a wall 3 feet wide and 6 feet tall that is 4,287 miles long. To give you an idea of how far this is, the distance from here to Los Angeles is 2,685 miles. The distance of all this trash lined up is 4,300 miles from here to Anchorage, Alaska. So what's in our garbage? What do you guys think? 38% of our garbage.
Food.
Paper.
Banana
pump. Paper. I heard paper. Paper is 38% of our garbage. This could be recycled. 18%, what do you guys think? Plastic. Also could be recycled. 14%.
Metal.
Metal. 11%. Any ideas? Yard waste, which could be composted. And 19% is other. So we obviously see the discrepancy between what's being thrown away and what could be recycled. So what are we missing? If we recycle 1 ton of paper, that saves 17 mature trees, 7,000 gallons of water, and 4,000 kilowatt hours of electricity. This is enough energy to power the average American home for 5 months. Also, 2.5 million plastic bottles are thrown away every hour. 90% will end up in landfills. So in 2007, San Francisco recycled 71% of their waste. They have a new program of mandatory recycling, with their end goal being zero waste. So in 2007, what percentage of waste do you think was recycled by Americans?
Hey.
Hey.
I'm
thinking
41.
Hey. No, B.
No! So much less than the 71% in San Francisco. How do you think Marylanders did overall?
37.
B.
41%. So we did a little bit better than the rest of the country. Prince George's County residents? So we're a little bit lower than the rest of the state. Okay. So if the entire country reached a 71% recycling rate, like San Francisco, we could reduce the landfill growth rate by 34%. So with this in mind, our project design is to think globally and act locally. And we are currently acting in Hyattsville, Maryland, part of Prince George's County. This year, Hyattsville implemented a pilot program. This pilot program had the goal to minimize costs for the city, and they went from a twice-a-week trash collection to a once-a-week collection. The additional goals were to try to reduce trash and possibly increase recycling. This leads us to our research question. Does the new pilot program decrease the amount of trash, increase recycling, and change people's attitudes? Also, we wanted to see if trash varied by income of residents. We have four main hypotheses. We hypothesize that the trash volume will decline, that the recycling volume will increase, that residents will be more aware of the program. And for our second question, we think that trash will vary by income level. To give us an idea of our methodology, I'll hand over to you.
Thank you, Jessica. So the way we set up in order to answer our research questions, we try to mix methods. What we're doing is mixed methodology and just testing quantitative and qualitative.
Thank you. Speaking of the market.
Oh, sorry. So we have, we're trying to find out if the pilot program has had a positive effect on trash and recycling. And so we have data before the pilot program was implemented in 2009 and after 2010, starting in January 2010. And we got the recycling data from PG County Waste Management Group, and we got the trash data from the High School Department of Public Works. So this is a graph of the data, and what we found was that trash was decreased, and it was a significant amount because of the pilot program. But recycling, there wasn't much of a change. But even though there wasn't that much of a change, there was a 2% increase after the pilot program was implemented. So maybe hope. With the house values of rats, we're trying to measure. Remember that we were, one of the research questions we're trying to figure out is